We have 3 3-minute rounds. This is for the 3FC Featherweight title, brought to you by Advocare. Making his way to the cage, fighting out of the red corner, David Mang.
I gotta be 89 in a street, something you heard. This is
the cage. He is the champion. Fighting out of Black Eye Fitness of Asheville, North Carolina. His current record, 5 wins, only 2 defeats. He is your 3FC Featherweight Champion.
All right, this is for the 3FC Featherweight Championship. David Mang, 1-0 in the black and red. Leo Perez, our champion, in the blue.
Good kick by Mang, first thing.
Mang, outstanding wrestler, one of the top wrestlers. He's only 1-0, but his win is against a guy who many are labeling the best prospect in the area, period, in Jonathan Pierce.
Definitely. You know, he came out and, you know, Mang's definitely been working on his stand-up a whole lot, throwing some good tie kicks right there to start off the
Kickboxing Valor. We've seen kickbox at the last 3FC show, and his opponent bounced on us. But Perez, on the other hand, very well-rounded, coming off a dominant win over Adam Hyde to win the title.
Yeah, Perez is definitely coming forward, and Mang finally, you know, gets in for the takedown here, working. But Perez, you know, showing good takedown defense. He's got, you know, got a wizard on the right hand side and trying to, you know, go ahead and turn him to the left. So Mang had the cage holding on there, and he, you know, got him right off there. Very good cage work by Perez.
Mang well rounded, said he was fine keeping it on the feet. But nonetheless, it is his world if we're wrestling. But so far, Leo Perez looks very comfortable in the clinch as well here, grappling with Mang. Oh, and that one went low.
Yeah, that's one thing I always notice about kids that wrestle. Got the training with Bradley Cobot. I mean, he had excellent wrestling. And then, you know, when I put him against the cage and, you know, things like that, he just acted like he, you know, it was a totally different, you know, alien world to him. So it's a lot of things that these wrestlers are adjusting to, is learning how to, you know, use that cage, because this cage is a huge part of MMA these days.
So a big difference in wrestling and MMA wrestling.
Definitely.
You see Mang still developing his MMA wrestling game. Leo Perez, on the other hand, much more experienced. This is his 8th fight, as this is Mang's 2nd MMA fight. So a big difference. Mang, though, a lot of people really high on him.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
His stand-ups look really good. Valor.
Yeah. I think I've reffed every one of his Valor fights. And, you know, kid looks great, man. It's surprising me how good his striking, you know, he is, especially being independent as well. You know, it's wild. Kid's definitely got talent. Needs to, you know,
try to do what he trains. Can. Perez trains Black Eye Fitness in Asheville with another guy we'll see in just a few minutes, Cody Gulley. The guy's got a really good camp. He's fought pretty much everywhere. This is his 2nd appearance in 3FC. Be interesting to see how he does against a solid wrestler, though.
He's from Asheville.
Yep. Trains with a lot of good guys down there. One of the top gyms in Asheville.
Yeah, both these are very, very high prospects. You know, it's crazy to call the, you know, Mang a prospect. You know, Mang's 1-0. Everybody's got very, very nice kick, very good left hook counter, though. And very good counter wrestling again by Perez. You know, this is a very good wrestling match right here.
Interesting seeing the wrestler land the big shot, the striker going for the clinch. But he might have seen some, but Mang's not very good being his back against the cage. So
Mang's corner calling for kicks, and he's really throwing them. He's throwing very good. One thing I don't like right now that Mang's doing is he's messing with his mouthpiece a lot. He needs to keep that chin down and that mouth closed.
It's a good way to get knocked out, moving your chin like that. Way. His hands stay a little low, too, and that's just normal for him. He don't put them up that much.
That dude throws planks, and very, very good. Very, very nice. You know, Perez, he fainted at him once or twice and noticed that Mang was ducking down and then fainted again through the 1-2 straight down the pipe. And, you know, very, very nice. Here he goes again with the same thing.
I would guess. No.
Wow.
That was close to being a huge hang. Oh, look at Mang go.
Man, those are some hard shots by Mang. Hard shots.
Mang is not trying to win a decision, trying to finish Perez. It's a deep double.
Very deep.
But Perez, impressive so far.
Wow, very.
There he goes.
Let's see how Perez does off his back right here. See if he decides to try to, you know, go ahead and get up on the cage. Action right here in front of us. And half guard, hard punches from David Mang. Mang a very heavy, hard-hitting fighter.
He is in half guard. It might as well be a mount. He is swinging.
Yes, he is.
Mang's grounded pound.
Very hard ground pound. Perez is definitely going to have to do something right here. This fight's about to be stopped.
Oh, and now
10 seconds left. Mang's got his back. Let's see what the choke looks like.
He finished Pierce with a rear naked. He might try another one. 10 seconds. And that will be the end of the round. Wow. David Mang.
Very, very, very exciting round.
David Mang trying to finish the fight.
Mang looks very tired right now. Let's see how he bounces back after that 30-second barrage of crazy punches.
He is an explosive wrestler, but man, he is just as explosive of a striker. Mang, very good round. You give that to Mang?
Oh, yeah. Mang definitely. Mang definitely got water all over him. Definitely, I think, stole that round, man. You mount somebody, you hit somebody the last 30 seconds as hard as you can for the whole 30 seconds. You got that round. I don't care what the other guy did the whole other round, man. That was very, very nice by Mang.
Interesting by Mang. When he gets him down, he's not working position. He is ground and pound all the way.
Yeah. Very, very hard shots by Mang. Those things were thudding right in front of us.
Going to the second round here.
Going to touch gloves the second round.
Right now looks like the challenger in control.
Yeah, very much. Very much. Come out and touch gloves.
Perez, he's got much more of a striker stance, but man.
He keeps trying to parry that jab, and Mang's really throwing a good left hook to come over top of that right-hand parry that Perez is trying to do, which is good for Mang. We watch for Uchimata here from Mang, possibly. Very, very nice cage work coming from Perez.
And Mang, still very young in his career. His amateur wrestling, outstanding. Still developing the all-around MMA wrestling game. So here, as you said, though, might set up some kind of throw.
Yeah, he looks like he's looking for Uchimata. He's going to try, you know, really deep whiz right here. He's grabbing that other hand, which is good. But really, when you got that whiz, you want to reach down and grab your own leg. And that gives you a lot more power. And then, you know, go ahead and press. Just go ahead and, you know, raise him back up and get rid of that whiz coming in. Really working very, very good cage work out there.
Not what we thought we'd see from Perez here. Kind of, he's the one icing.
He's got the wheel. Now he's got on his leg now. So now he's really going to try to work for that right there.
See if Perez maybe can get a takedown here. Yeah. Perez might be more about control right now.
Yeah, I mean, Perez should keep doing what he's doing, man. He's dirty boxing the heck out of Perez right now. He hit Perez with a body shot right there. It really hurt him. Perez buckled. I saw it in his face right there, and he got hit that body shot. So, you know, see if he goes back to body or if he even noticed.
Both guys, very impressive. Mang's cardio a little unproven too, so the later rounds, it'll be interesting to see Perez coming off.
That's what I'm saying.
A 12-minute fight.
I don't know. Like I said, Mang looked really tired after that first round out there, and come back out in the second round. He's not trying to get off the cage at all. He's just comfortable being there. He don't feel like he's going to get taken down. That's why he's comfortable being there. And I know from experience, you can't swing your back on the cage and win a round.
They're going to break him here.
Break him up.
Perez looked like he was working.
I don't agree
well.
With that at all. I don't agree with that call at all.
That's good for Mang.
Yeah, definitely good for Mang.
Oh, and that was Mang.
Take it! Oh, my God! Overhand right!
Taking control here. Mang to try to finish this fight.
Very, very good. Very hard punch. Very hard punches. Very hard punches for Mang. He better finish. If not, he's going to be very tired. He's weathering the storm, though. Jimmy Neely calling for him to work. He reaches for an armbar. Almost gets it. Now trying to sweep. Mang going to turn around. Oh, very nice.
Perez using his long legs to kind of – oh, but look at Mang. Mang is slowing down.
This is over. This fight's about to be over, boys. Perez is just laying there getting it.
Oh, and Mang might take us back or right in the mount here.
Very end of the round, though. Yeah, I believe it's about to come to a very second. Let's see how this round goes.
This might be it, though, man.
Very, very close. We're trying to push off. He's bridging. He's on the cage. He's working.
He's high.
He's got 10 seconds left. Let's see if he holds it or finishes it. He needs a breeze.
Mang is going to try to finish this fight.
I think Jimmy Neal is going to let it go the third round.
Oh, Perez looks like he may survive. That'll be it.
Wow.
Mang is exhausted.
That might be huge for Perez because Mang might be gassed. Mang might be gassed. Wow, though. When Mang gets on top of you, it's raining. It's raining punches the whole time.
Yeah, Mang is exhausted. Now, it's going to be very curious to see how Mang comes out this third round. He's not even on the stool yet. He's still laying there.
Not a good sign. For the David Mang camp.
You know, but at the same time, I mean, you know, taking that much punishment is going to take it out of you, too. It's just not going to be just as fun as Mang. You know, he's not going to be as tired, you know, physically, but mentally, it's going to be very, very hard for
Perez to come out this third round knowing what, you know, he just got his butt kicked that second half of the round.
Can't really see Perez, but I mean, that flirt at the end, you got to say, that's 2-0, oh,
yeah,
Mang, right?
Yeah, it has to be. There's no way that they can get more than that from how it was up there. Third round, Mang still leaning against the fence. If I was Mang's corner, I would throw a bunch of water on the floor and maybe nearly give it up and get about an extra 20 seconds of rest there.
Well, it's going to be interesting here because you would have got to think.
Title fight.
You got to think for Perez's standpoint, he has to finish right now.
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, the bad part about it is if Mang really gasses and you know, throws it on, Mang gasses and Perez throws it on him this round and it goes to a 10-8 round or something like that, we could possibly see a draw because Mang looks exhausted. Good.
Oh, man. Good jab from
very
Perez.
Good jab. There you go. Oh, stay up.
That's one of those I don't want to stand no more shoots.
Yeah, that's one of them that I got to get a takedown because I'm exhausted right now.
That's not
the worst kind of shot because he don't even want to do nothing.
It's
going to be completely hard for him to get up each and every time.
That's not the David Mang shoots we usually see. Breathing hard, mouth wide open.
Jab right hand, left hand. He's waiting. He might see a kick to the head right here in just a second if Perez is smart.
No knees in amateur, but you can throw a front kick. Oh, man, he can barely stand almost. Yeah. His hands aren't staying up.
Mang's very tired. I'm telling you, that's a shot that he don't that... kick him.
Perez.
Right, 1-2. This looks, God, he caught him with the right hand right there. His striking looks, reminds me a lot of the Nick Diaz. It's real long and rangy. Very, very, very good.
If you've not seen the Adam Hyde fight, that is a Nick Diaz fight. Shots to the body, body, head. And we're seeing now Perez grappling.
You know, Perez has got the back of Mang right here. Mang was kind of laying there. This is kind of probably the worst case possible, worst case scenario for him to have. And got a choke.
That in, that's in.
It looks like it's in pretty deep to me. No, it's on the chin. And I think it just went in.
Perez.
He must have pushed his face out of the way. Very good defense.
Mang might go to sleep, man.
No, he ain't.
Oh, no. Is it in? Can you see where it's?
No, it's just definitely in. Mang's still fighting, though. Mang's still fine, but that choke is in. But he's off to the angle. He's not got a good angle for it. That boy is squeezing for dear life. Mang is still fighting. Mang is so tough. Very exciting fight. Very exciting.
Is that it? He's sleeping. That is it.
He ain't sleeping. He ain't sleeping. He was pushing his hand.
Oh.
He was pushing his hand. He was not. He was pushing his hand up. How are you going to throw that out? Wow.
Wow.
He was nowhere near out. He was pushing his hand up.
Mang holding on for dear life in a fight. He was winning. But now, Perez defends.
I think Perez is cussing the ref right now. Wow. Very wild.
Wow. Wow.
I mean, it's a Kyle regardless. Thomas.
It's interesting to see, man.
Yeah,
I
mean, keep the language down, okay? David, get up.
That's some bullshit. Mang, very good in this fight, man. I mean, outstanding, but this is not the first odd call we've had tonight.
Yeah,
we've had a quick stop.
Definitely, it was very, very unfortunate, mishap for any fighter. I mean, I definitely understand, his pain coming from that. But you got to look. The referee is definitely trying to,
protect him.
Yeah. And definitely not trying to hurt him anyway. Of course, he didn't want to make that the wrong call, but sometimes it happens. And he was trying to save Mang's life and not let him get choked for 10 seconds.
My God, Perez had that rear naked choke in for probably about a minute.
Yeah. Oh man, that choke was in.
And it was good. When they started to roll, you can see it was there. Just Mang, just.
Wild
call. We will go to the decision. Leo Perez defends the 3FC Featherweight Championship in a.
Oh,
no, it is a. We're going to call it a rear naked choke submission, I guess. Yeah. You would think we'd get a decision, but.
That's what they should do. They should go ahead and call a decision. That's what happened in Hogan's last time.
We've seen it, yeah. You go right to the decision. There's conspiracy, but.
No,
conspiracy. Ref stops it. This is a submission victory and a title defense for Leo Perez.
Ladies and gentlemen, the fight stops at 2:11 in the third round. Your winner by submission by rear naked choke. the win. You defended your title. Now, you got a heck of an opponent here, David Mang. 1-0. I didn't know what to expect. We saw what he did in his last fight. Saw how he was very dominant. He came out and kind of got you in trouble in round one and round two. Were you worried at all?
No, I've got experience. I mean, he cracked me some good times, but seeing why and seeing stars and just days a little bit. That's just with the experience. He's 1-0. I didn't know what to expect either. And good wrestling. He's shorter. He's really sick. When I'm trying to wait for the shots, that's what I was doing. I was waiting too much, and then he would crack me, and he caught me. And once I tried a head kick, and he shot in. So.
Do you think he just ran out of gas? It seemed like your cardio was still there come the third round. It seemed like he was a little bit gas, a little bit tired. Is that when he knew to kind of go in for the kill there against the cage?
Well, I won this title. So to be holding this title, you don't want to lose because of your cardio. So I trained my cardio very well, Black Eye. And I'm not going to lose because of that. If it comes in the third round, I'm going to come back. I'm going to fight like a champion and win this belt. And that's what I did out here. He was a great opponent, tough wrestler, tough kid. Maybe we'll see each other down the road, but this might be my last amateur, and that was a hell of a way to end an amateur career. That's what I plan on doing next.
Well, I'll tell you what, if you don't end your amateur career, you already have your number one contender. We decided that tonight, Jamal Muhammad, had a fantastic fight over here over Bo Priest. What message do you have for Jamal Muhammad as the champion of what he needs to do when he faces you?
I didn't really get to see him fight. I heard it sounded like a good fight. I saw him training in the back for a little bit. I know he was looking at me, trying to get a little heads up, but we ended up fighting. You better train hard, because I'm not quitting.
Is there anybody else you want to thank?
I want to thank my Black Eye team, all my training partners, all the people that came out from North Carolina. This is for you guys. And get ready for Juicebox Gully. For the Grand Prix, he's going to win that against Sex Leg, so let's watch the fight and see what happens.
Well, there he is, guys. Give it up, your featherweight champion, Leo Danger Perez.